I'm waiting for someone.
The door is broke. It'll be fifth time or so it don't open.
Maybe there's a penny stuck in there.
Why a penny?
I don't know.
Did you stick a penny in there?
No, I was just making small talk.
If I find a penny in there, I'm taking you down.
And like that, I got a second wind.
I'm watching you.
That workday started like every other.
How's it going?
I'm 37 years old and I'm a janitor. How do you think it's going?
Now, there is nothing wrong with being a janitor.
Really? Thank you. You've turned my life around. I'm going to have to go tell my janitor wife and all our janitor kids that life is worth living. And that comes straight from our hero, Dr. Who's-its. Dr. Nothing. No, seriously, come on. You can come over to my humble house and point out things that are cheap.
I'm thinking about asking Carl out today. What do you think?
I think the janitors have to get me.
Wow. Thank you so much for your help. You know what? Why don't you be just a little bit more paranoid?
Wait, Turk.
That's him.
If you ask me about a personal problem, I'm going to start doing this.
Ow!
You seem unhappy. I like that.
Have you seen Turk?
Yeah, I saw him. He just went out that door. Turk? Can't hear you. What? You love who?
Dr. Kelso. Hi, I wanted to get your opinion about a patient. She's a 74-year-old renal failure, Mrs. Tanner.
Oh, of course. One of our frequent flyers. She's a neat lady.
That's what I said.
Nobody likes a brown nose, son. Put her on diuretics.
Yeah, I ordered them.
These labs don't look good. I think it's time she got started on dialysis.
Oh, the janitor. This guy is always bothering me. Don't look at him. Don't talk to him. Don't...
What's your point? Ammonia too strong?
Oh, no, I have a...
That's one. Keep pushing.
And there's what? Page.
This better be good. Paging the chief of medicine.
Fine work, doctor. Fine work.
I hear that.
Ammonia's a little strong today.
That's two.
Screwcocks!
I mean, you're not afraid of them, are you?
Hell no!
Okay, maybe a little.
That's four.
That's three.
That's five.
Is there anybody up there, up there, up there, up there? I'm all alone down here.
It's cold.
I'm frightened.
Just keep moving. Refocus.
Sorry.
Happy Halloween.
Maybe that'll teach you not to spy on people during their alone time.
So what, you just like, you'll flip the coin in your head, or?
No. It's just that right now he's better at internal medicine than you are.
Okay, go, you know, insult me like you always do.
Too easy. When you least expect it.
Well?
Not yet, but soon. Very soon.
Tick-tock, Clarice.
You're stupid.
That's it?
Give it time. It'll eat at you.
Am I stupid?
Yeah, a little bit.
Damn him.
Did you lose something?
No. Why? Did you take something?
No.
What'd you take?
Nothing.
What'd you take?
Newbie, come.
When I saw that it was missing, did you not think I'd come to you?
I don't know what you're talking about.
So you're gonna play it that way, huh? Touché. Here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna leave the cart in the closet. I'm gonna leave the closet unlocked. If, by magic, it should happen to reappear, I won't ask any questions.
I don't even know what it is.
Then why take it?
I just dropped my pen.
Well, look what magically found its way back home.
What? Your window cleaner?
No, ammonia. This is window cleaner. Right there.
Why? Now that's just bad luck. On the bright side, it'll be interesting to see what it feels like to be a patient.
You know people die here.
You're a good friend.
Yeah, I do know I'd come. Can I have your stuff?
Hey, I'm watching that.
It's broken.
Okay, you know, it's time to change this pattern.
Morning.
How do you figure?
Just doing a little drilling, huh? Look, I have an idea. Let's try and go the whole day without getting in each other's hair. You know, just give each other a break. What do you say?
I'm gonna give you a nickname.
That's good, but you know, I have a nickname. It's JD.
How about Whiny Face? Whiny Britches. Whiny something. I definitely like whiny. Whiny Dancer. Hey, from now on, your name is Scooter.
I don't get it.
Short for Scooter Pie. I hate Scooter Pies.
Oh, now I see.
You big jerk.
She called me Bambi in front of everyone. My name is not Bambi.
It's Scooter. Short for Scooter Pie.
But thanks, Bambi.
From that moment on, I knew I'd be Bambi forever.
See you tomorrow, Scooter.
He's actually very talented.
Who put this up?
I did. I drove around the whole city before my 5 a.m. shift, just looking for that. Trying to add a little cheer. You will not ruin my Christmas. Not again. Not this year.
But I've only worked here for 3 months. Ooh, hey, candy. I was trying to,
Oh, I know exactly what you're trying to do, but you're not gonna break my Christmas spirit. You can't. Not ever. I'm the holly jolly janitor. Hi, little girl, what do you want for Christmas?
Hey!
What? I didn't say anything, I didn't do anything. What imaginary slight have you concocted in that paranoid little brain of yours? Crap. Well, shouldn't there be some sort of sign that's a... Oh. Look at that. Well, you should put it back down before someone slips and falls.
Oh, is that what I should do? Good. Because I make most of my decisions based on your opinion. You know what I'm thinking of splitting up with the wife? Maybe you can mull that one over, get back to me. We can powwow. Floor's wet, man. Little help over here. Little help.
Man, she's beautiful. I wish I was that piece of bacon.
Wait a second. I am that piece of bacon.
That's right.
You mind not staring at me while I'm eating? I hate it.
But I'm not. I was...
What am I doing right now?
Eating.
What are you doing?
Staring.
Okay. There. Now no one gets to eat it. You happy?
Not really.
You're only 80 minutes late. She'll still be here. Please be here. Come on, Alex. Please be here. Please be here. Please.
You gotta be kidding me. There's a waste of a gift certificate. Cancel the cobbler.
For some guys, that would be distracting, but I'm staying focused.
You're on my foot.
Oh, God, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry.
Oh, no, please step on my foot. I'm just waiting for an excuse.
Not today.
Really? Why not? Ah, I get it.
Yeah.
Nice pull.
Thanks.
Slept with her yet?
What? I am not discussing that with you.
That's a no.
Listen, Jolly Green. People's personal lives are just that. They're personal.
That's a definite no.
Tonight we'll pick up right where we left off.
$20 says it never happens. What, you're offended?
Hey, tell me something. What do you think about Alex?
No way. I'm not saying anything about a girl that you're sleeping with.
I'm not sleeping with her.
I'm sorry I couldn't make it.
She seems sorry. I am too.
After that, things pretty much got back to normal.
Give me $20.
No, but I never even made...
$20.
So, there it is. Oh, and if you go ahead and listen very carefully, you'll hear the familiar sound of no one caring.
I like that guy. Girl problems?
How'd you know?
You look like you got problems. You're a girl. Hence, girl problems. Watch your nails.
Ugh. Could Turk have picked anyone worse to be doing this project with?
If this is a peripheral vascular disease study, then I find it essential to exclude all claudication patients not currently on pentoxifylline. What are you looking at?
I just don't think it's my fault he quit.
I don't know. I think most of the bad things that happen around here are your fault.
I was talking to her. There's no reason to start obsessing. You did nothing wrong.
Morning, killer. Have a good one, killer.
Help you, sir?
Sir?
You can help me by minding your own damn business.
Excuse me?
Oh, aggressive, huh? Do you really want to get it on with me, Pimp Squeak? Because if you do, I guarantee it'll be the last stupid thing you ever do on God's green earth.
It's nice meeting you.
What the hell was that all about?
Dad! Wander off like that.
Hey, you missed a spot right there.
Well, lucky for me, Dad, I spend my life going in a big circle around this place cleaning up after sick people. So tomorrow I'll probably be here about the same time.
You know that I hate sass, so just drop right down and give me 20.
Dad, that could be fecal matter.
Make it 30.
Fine.
What is it with parents anyway? Why is it so easy for them to make us feel bad?
Sound off like you've got a pair. You know, this has got to be the most piss poor, sorry excuse for a hospital that I have ever set foot in.
Yeah, well, Dad, in that case, feel free not to stop by every day you're in town.
Goodbye, son. I'll see you tomorrow.
Hey, parents, huh?
Tell me about it.
Yeah. What's that, a shot at my dad? That's stepping over the line, pal.
I missed this.
It wasn't a race.
okay, fine. Let's just play, let's play tip over the trash can. Okay? I win.
I win.
Can I play? This is fun.
Yeah.
I spoke to some other people.
Like who?
All fixed.
He's a janitor.
Yeah, but he seems confident.
I know what I'm telling you is the right way to go, and I am not going to take no for an answer. So what do you say?
Okay, let's do it.
You won. Now beat it.
What?
No. Let's get you some sherbet.
I'm sure you'll be fine.
Wait, here's your pen.
Keep it.
Bum bum ba bum bum ba bum 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 bum.
Gee, is he gonna make it?
It doesn't look good. We've secretly replaced this doctor's blood with hepatitis blood. Let's see if he notices.
You know, I could be really sick here. Could you be nice for once in your life?
How's that?
Hey, I thought about what you said before, and you're right. I haven't been that nice.
And?
That's it. What, do you want to go to a ball game tonight and share a big tub of popcorn? That's the last time I reach out. Anybody want to go to a, not you.
The truth is, the hematopathologist was the last person in this hospital I wanted to deal with.
No! Why do you have to jump out and scare me all the time?
I don't jump out and scare you. I follow you around all day. Only got about an hour and a half worth of work around here, and the rest of the time I track you like an animal.
You're kidding, right?
I don't know. Am I?
Oh my God, I can't believe I'm about to do this.
What's wrong?
I lost my mop.
Really?
No. That's the only thing that can make me unhappy, right? You people, you think of me as nothing but the janitor.
That's not true.
What's my name?
I know the nurses call you Sir Plunge-a-Lot.
I know.
And come on, I'm sure you don't know my name, so...
John Michael Dorian.
I should know my middle name.
Because I care.
Your mother's maiden name is Turner.
So you used your key to get into my personnel file. Big deal.
Your first kiss was with Sarah Briggs at the embarrassing age of 16. She wore a green turtleneck, and you wonder sometimes if she still thinks about you. I'm guessing no.
How could you possibly know that?
I'm your father. You're afraid of escalators.
That's not uncommon.
You like the way cashmere feels on your skin.
How are you doing this?
That's right. You run away.
Run away from the truth!
Always be a hero to me. What a girl. You must forget. Theater camp. Bingo.
All right, enough is enough.
Woo! I guess I don't fit in with your mirror friends. Enjoy.
Maybe if you tell him how hard it is on you, he'll get better. I'll get paper towels.
Don't worry about it. Somebody else will get it.
Yeah. Who can we get? I'm not shocked. That's how you live your life, isn't it? Got a problem? Hey, just pass it on down the line. Hey, congratulations on becoming a resident. Glad I could help.
Help? You were awful to me. You awful.
Anyway, go get him, Tiger. The world is your oyster, my friend. What?
It's my first day. I'm waiting for someone.
This door's broke. It'll be fifth time or so it don't open.
Maybe there's a paperclip stuck in there.
Why a paperclip?
I was just making small talk.
Did you put a paperclip in there?
No.
If I find a paperclip, you're going down.